yesterday, didn't think he would be able to return for Nebraska. He is their number one return man, and there's their number one eye back, Derrick Brown, back deep with him. Scott Blanton set on that sideline. Brad Riddell will handle the kickoffs. He also is the punter for Oklahoma. He has the stronger leg, so he will kick it off here from the 35. On a rainy, blustery afternoon in Lincoln, we're underway. Derrick Brown Oklahoma expects some field position. Stiggy back close to the end of the end zone as he takes the snap. Hangs one high. Oklahoma will let it bounce. They're going to have wonderful field position at the 33-yard line. Surgery. So after a two-week layoff, he comes back now to quarterback for the Sooners.
The decision by Gibbs to kick off after winning the toss. Hey, the super decision, the first one made correctly in the ball game. Nice to start out on the positive side in decision making.
Here is Gundy, the 6-foot sophomore. Oklahoma threatening on its first series, and Gundy to put it up. Receivers covered, so he will take off. And Gundy fumbles. Ball was down at the 15-yard line. Let's see how the officials rule it, whether or not he was down.
That looks like they're marking it down on the 1-foot line. Good extra effort by Gaddis. Again, boy, that ball just popping out.
Overloads in the backfield. Gundy keeps it himself and goes into the end zone. The officials waiting to see the football in Gundy's possession. There's the signal for the touchdown. Oklahoma strikes first in the big one. Was the fumble on the opening kickoff, which buried Nebraska in bad field position. Punting against the wind, Oklahoma was able to move in on its first possession. McCant straight back, fakes to the back, tries to set the middle pass, and it's Johnny Mitchell, the tight end. First down, Nebraska. And rose quickly to starting status after the injury to Thomas has. And that time, the snap is fumbled. Oklahoma ball.
Look up here that Keaton McCant pulled out.
Vibrant. I spoke with Bill Shepard, who's in charge of maintaining the field here, and he said despite the rain, the field's in good playing conditions. He actually said the field plays better when it's a little wet. His only concern is that if the temperature drops, the field becomes extremely icy. In the meantime, one of the biggest concerns for the Nebraska trainers is keeping the players warm. They're moving along the sidelines. There's several heaters down here, Brent. One definitely has my name on it.
All right, get over close to it.
Those basketball players aren't very tough, Brent.
It's a twisting run and a penalty flag. Drops down to the quarterback's right. Draw play, Nebraska not fooled. Good defensive play by John Perella, number 92.
He has really improved Nebraska's offense.
Now McCant, the pullback up very close, running the option to the right, and again extremely well defended by Oklahoma. Joe Holder pulled out a tie. Now McCant firing, intercepted by Oklahoma, and fumbled out of bounds, but it's Oklahoma ball. With the 25th interception of the season for the Sooners, and conditions like this, that toss now to Gaddis, looks for daylight, squeezes through, takes it to the 22-yard line. Fumble! Oklahoma! And it was
runs. That's one of the disadvantages of running an option offense. And
option man is Ted Long. Gaddis, right side hole, cut back to the 32 and close to a first down. Perella, who has been so active defensively, as the receiver goes in motion, you know who. Gaddis battling short of the goal by a fourth down. Gaddis to the middle, to the top, and stopped short of the end zone. No, they give it to him. Oh, I thought for sure Nebraska had him short of the end zone. There's a penalty flag now thrown from the far side as Gaddis, with his second effort, battles on into the end zone. We're going to take a break, and then we'll come back and review that touchdown. It was close. Be definitive on these replays, and we'll show you why. It was Gaddis pounding in on fourth and one. Now, the person who had the best view is the linesman coming down. Watch immediately as he views where Gaddis is with the football. The arms will come up. He did downs against this OU defense. McCann faking. Now he'll throw to a wide open Mitchell. And the Nebraska tight end comes up with a... down as Chris Wilson makes a spectacular defensive play for the... So Bennett puts the Cornhuskers on the scoreboard. 6:58 to go in the first half. A 22-yard field goal.
Get back to that point I was going to make. Larry Coker, the offensive coordinator for Oklahoma, made the statement yesterday he did not think the weather would be a negative for their style of offense. If anything, he thought it would be their advantage because they came here to run, and they were going to run straight upfield most of the time.
Oklahoma 14, Nebraska 3. Gaddis slips outside, short of the first down as Curtis Cotton runs about in the first half. We had four turnovers, three of them by Nebraska. And down we go to Cheryl Miller. Cheryl?
Coach Gibb, the weather is absolutely terrible, but so far it hasn't really affected your team.
Well, it has, you know, as far as their footing, holding on the football, some things we want to try to do, but we just got to go out and continue to play through the elements to secure the football.
You're going into the second half with an 11-point lead. Are you going to continue to keep the ball on the field? You're going to put it in the air?
Well, again, we've got to try to secure the football. We want to be able to throw it, but we got to be able to secure it from the quarterback to the center of the quarterback. And, you know, we just got to, again, try to get Mike Gaddis loose a little bit.